Song by Nox, my guest interviewed today, and it's called Melody featuring Master KG. Welcome to Everyday People. How are you?
I'm good, I'm good. That's not brand new though.
It's not brand new. Thomas! Literally throwing me under the bus, no, but it's all good.
Not really, it's like my latest
song. Yeah, okay.
I think that's what he was trying to say.
Okay, absolutely. Welcome to Everyday People. How are you?
I'm alright, thank you for having me.
Absolutely, a pleasure. Now let's get at the red carpet for you.
Yeah.
Inna Kunguni, better known for his stage name Nox, is a Zimbabwean urban grooves singer, songwriter, performer, and record producer. Nox started his musical career in 2002, after attending a reality music show called Superstar 22. And when he started his degree in Midlands State University, he joined Shape Zimbabwean Projects, where he was spotted by the renowned musician Roy and Royce Agomo, who worked with him, and his very first single, Iwe Maria, am I pronouncing it right?
Yes, you are.
Absolutely. Iwe Maria was produced, and the hit song was a great musical journey. Now, fast forwarding in 2020, despite being lyrically talented, you can tell that you are actually lyrically talented, because the lyrics on the song are absolutely amazing, and we're going to get straight into it later on. Lyrically talented marked the release of Nox's official clothing brand, which should be available this summer of last year. Actually, it is available, right?
Yes, it is.
Absolutely. Nox works closely hand in hand with his brother Typha, who is also signed under the Ice and Roses label. Typha has produced one of the hit songs in Nox's career over the years and continues to do so till today. So welcome to Everyday People.
Thank you.
Now let's take it way back. Let's start it from the actual beginning.
Yeah.
Growing up in Zimbabwe, who is Nox outside the musical journey?
Nox is a businessman.
Mm-hmm.
I did a marketing degree, by the way, most people don't know that.
Mm-hmm.
But I was way back, 2003, my first year in varsity.
Mm-hmm.
Graduated in 2007. I was a distinction kind of a student.
Okay. Hey now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I learned how to talk. I learned how to market.
Mm-hmm.
So my parents always wanted me to finish school, but I loved music more.
Mm-hmm.
But at the end of the day, I had to make sure that I make the two work together.
Absolutely.
So yeah. So now I'm using my knowledge of school and business to market myself and my music and my business, which is really
working well. It was actually going to be my second question.
Oh.
And how do you merge the business side of things, as well as your musical career, with everything that you have going on?
It's very easy for me, because, you know, when you specialize on what you like,
mm-hmm.
which is your talent, you never work one day of your life.
Yes.
I'm telling you. And ever since, it's just been an amazing journey, because this is what I like to do. This is what I love to do. Music is what I love to do.
Absolutely.
But then I make sure that I take what I learned at school,
mm-hmm.
I put it into my music.
Practically.
And I think that's why I'm here today, because you guys have noticed me, have noticed what I'm doing,
mm-hmm.
and that's because of the business side of things, which is marketing, which is what I went to school for.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And now, since you started off your career in 2002.
Yeah.
Why do I keep saying 2020? 2020 used to leave us alone.
Yeah.
Back in 2002,
yeah.
How has that journey been from 2002 up until now? I mean, you have so many accolades, many records, and now you are here.
It hasn't been easy, you know, I don't want to lie. It's been very, very difficult. Most of the people that we started with,
mm-hmm.
most of them gave up. Most of them chose other career paths.
Mm-hmm.
But I remained true to what I believe, true to what I love.
Absolutely.
And you know what they say, if you never give up, in the end, God is going to reward you for that.
Mm-hmm.
And I never gave up. I'm one of those few people who started the journey of the new school in 2002 and are still here and relevant.
Yes.
And that's because I never gave up. I believed in what I do. And if you believe in what you do so much, everybody else will believe in what you believe in.
Absolutely.
So that's what I've just said to myself, you know what, they have to believe in this because I believe in this. And one day I'm going to make it. And I think I'm on the right way.
Now, with so many difficult times that we live in, especially at 2020 with COVID-19 and stuff like that, how have you remained relevant to the masses, especially your fans?
I stay in South Africa, that's one.
Mm-hmm.
And my main market was in Zimbabwe.
Mm-hmm.
But I had to remain relevant. So, you know, you have to always research what's happening right now. What is relevant in that particular moment. And in your music and in whatever you give to the people, it has to be relevant.
Absolutely.
So you need to understand that if you do not research what's happening in this particular moment and try to be relevant, you will not be relevant.
Yeah.
Because you're not relating to what's happening right about now. But then, you know, as time moved on, I broadened my spectrum and now I'm more of an African artist.
Mm-hmm.
And this year, 2021, we just want to take the crown from Nigeria to Southern Africa, and I'm going to be the guy to be doing that.
So much confidence. I love it.
I'm telling you.
I love it. Now, speaking of your musical journey, with the latest songs that you've just released, can people expect a full body of work for you? And what is it that makes you thrive more when it comes to taking the crown from Zimbabwe and bringing it to South Africa?
2021, as I said, there's a lot that's happening. For starters, I've done 3 songs with Master KG.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the guy was when I was telling you about relevancy.
Yeah.
Yeah, relevant in practice. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And then after that, I've done something with DJ Tira.
Okay.
Yeah, I've done it.
So you're literally on the pulse of being relevant.
Yeah, I'm just going wherever there's relevance.
And it's beautiful.
Thank you very much. And from here, I'm going to go up east.
Yeah?
Yeah, I'm going to go up east. And then from there, I'm going to go up north to Nigeria. Then I'm done. I'm the African king, man. After that.
I love his swag, guys. You can see how he is in person. Like, seriously, his swag is on point. And the confidence on point.
Thank you.
Now, taking us to the latest track that you did with Master KG, how did that come about?
It really happened by accident, I don't want to lie.
Mm-hmm.
Because my first port of call was Makadzi.
Yeah.
That's who we went for. And for some reason, that didn't really work out.
Okay.
Yeah, we didn't really get to do it.
You see how God is...
Hey. Yeah, you know, and that time, Master KG wasn't really Master KG.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was within that period of Jerusalem, but before, you know.
Yeah. Before
and
we hit the
beat, so we're like, okay, what's next now? You know, this didn't work out. And then we're like, Master KG is available.
Mm-hmm.
We went to Master KG. Immediately we gelled. We became very good friends. We went there for one track. We came up there with 3 songs. One was a business track that we paid for.
Mm-hmm.
2 were for free.
Washa.
Same thing happened with DJ Tira.
Mm-hmm.
And the list goes on. But now 2021 is where everything is just gonna, you know, start to manifest.
Hey guys. Hey. No. Like you're rubbing off on me.
Yeah.
I love it.
The energy, like,
The energy is amazing.
Thank you.
And I love the fact that you speak things into existence. I feel like with a lot of musicians, they kind of like jump on the wagon and then they get lost
along the way.
Yeah. And with you, it's beautiful because you know what to do and who to work with and who to align your brand with.
Yeah.
And it's absolutely beautiful.
Thank you.
Taking me to my next question, who inspires you?
It's the fans, man. The fans inspire me all the time. When I go on stage, for example, you know, I can't even explain the feeling. Like, I can tell you, 2 weeks ago, there was this friend of mine that had a show in Joburg, a very big show. And they're very popular artists. And then they were having their show, and I went there, and they invited me on stage. The rest is history.
Okay.
One big mistake, though, but worked my advantage.
Yeah.
But I'm trying to say that, you know, the fans give me the zeal and they give me the power to move on and to work harder and to always try and do what they don't expect.
Yeah.
Yeah, and that alone is an inspiration for me to work hard and for me to venture into new things that people don't expect of me.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And I love the fact that the people that you give yourself to actually inspire your growth.
Yeah.
And now, what can people expect in the year of 2021? Are you dropping an album very soon? Can we get exclusives, Nyana, right here?
You know what? When it comes to that, last year, let me tell you a little story.
Mm-hmm.
Last year, I was doing something with Master KG.
Yeah.
And then I set out a date of when I'm going to release the song.
Mm-hmm.
You know what happened on that date?
COVID.
No, not COVID. COVID was better. What happened is some other artists dropped their tunes the same day.
Mm-hmm.
You know why?
Why?
Just to divide the attention.
Okay.
But at the end of the day, I won. But now I learned something.
Yeah.
I'm not going to tell what I'm doing and when I'm doing.
Okay.
It's just going to be a surprise.
Can we get, on the day that you decide to drop,
I'll tell you.
Just get a call and be like, okay, I'm dropping this right now so that we get exclusives. I love exclusives.
Most definitely.
And now for people inspired by your journey, obviously you inspire a lot of people across Africa and the African continent at large.
Yeah.
What would you love to say to them?
Never give up, man, because what men has done, men can do.
Mm-hmm.
You know, someone went to the moon the first time, it means that it can be done.
Yeah.
So what men has done, men can do. So I'm not afraid of anything. Whatever that has been done can be replicated and be done more and more. That's
Absolutely.
What I want to do, and that's why I'm here. I want to make sure that whatever every musician has achieved,
yeah,
I can topple that. I can do that and more.
Yeah.
Because
do you have any shows lined up here in South Africa?
Yeah.
In Cape Town specifically?
Yeah, specifically, I've got something tomorrow.
Okay.
I don't know if I'm allowed to say
you
where.
You are allowed to say it.
Okay, I'm at Mac Adams tomorrow.
Okay.
Yeah, and then on Sunday, I'm at the Gardens. It's a family thing from afternoon, mm-hmm, 12 to 8. So yeah, that's what I'm doing here in Cape Town. And the rest of the things I'm doing here is top secret.
FBI.
You know, man.
And now, where can people find you on social media?
I'm Nox Guni, NOXGUNI.
Thank you so much for taking the time to come to Everyday People. I wish you all the best in your career. I wish you nothing but the best of the best. You're such a great person. Your energy is infectious. Like, guys, his energy is literally infectious. And thank you so much for gracing us with your presence. I wish you nothing but the best on your musical journey. And please, when you drop that album, hit me up.
Yeah, please, I got something here, man. Thank you for
exactly.
having me. And may God bless Bush Rachel and bless you
in particular.
And yeah, everything you wish for me, I wish to you back.
Thank you so much. Absolutely. That is a Nox Anguni, my guest for today. And he has a brand new single. Actually, it's not even brand new. It's just right now. It's currently hot. It's My Melody featuring Master KG. We played it at the beginning. We're going to play it one more time. You are still keeping it locked right here on Everyday People Drive with myself, Upiwa Gomanata, better known as Lady P.